സി ജനറൽ സെക്രട്ടറി മുകുൾ വാസ്നിക് ഇപ്പോൾ തിരുവനന്തപുരത്ത് മാധ്യമങ്ങളോട് സംസാരിക്കുന്നു. അതിലേക്ക്
to the people of India, whether it was about employment to the youth, remunerative prices to the farmers, farm produce, whether it is concerning women's safety, whether it was regarding strengthening the Indian economy, whether it was in dealing with corruption, whether it was giving 15 lakh rupees in every account, on every single count, Modi government has failed miserably. Rather, one can say that the promises which he had made in 2014 elections were merely to garner votes. There was no sincerity behind that. He stands completely exposed before the people of India, and in no way there will be any support coming up for Modi. We have come up with our manifesto. We have articulated our views on very important issues. Apart from the two different vision of India, the one which we represent means we are representing the vision of India as enshrined in the Constitution of India, and the BJP and RSS represent the idea of India which basically was articulated by Mr. Hegdewar, Golwalkar, and today by Mr. Bhagwat. There is a total difference between both the ideas of India, and we have promised that today also there are poor people, those who cannot earn 12,000 rupees a month as a family. Those poor families will be given 6,000 rupees a month, 72,000 rupees a year, which means 3,60,000 rupees a year. This will be provided to about 5 crore families, which in a way will be received by 25 crore people of India. This is not the only one. We will be coming up with a separate budget to be presented before the Lok Sabha on farmers. We are going to come up with strategies to fill up all the vacant positions in the government of India and at various levels, which are about 22 lakh, by March end 2020. We have said that in the first session of Parliament immediately after the elections, we will be coming up with legislation providing 33% reservation for women in Parliament and state assemblies. We will also be providing 33% reservation for women in central government jobs. So there are various aspects, and I think Kerala will give us a historic verdict this time. See, Shashi Tharoor ji has been talking to me. He has been appreciating the hard work and the sincere efforts which the UDF partners at every single level in Trivandrum constituency have been doing. He is appreciative of the support being extended by every section within the UDF, and it is based on the support from all the UDF partners at various levels in Trivandrum that he has been able to represent Trivandrum for the last 10 years. And there is no doubt that with the support of all the UDF partners in Trivandrum, Mr. Shashi Tharoor ji will once again receive the mandate from the people of Trivandrum, and he will represent them in the Parliament
then
of India.
Then why AICC appointed a special observer in Trivandrum?
No, there is no such thing as any special observer. I think there are misunderstandings about this. We as a party have people going to various constituencies, and in other constituencies also there are some leaders who have gone there to coordinate the efforts. So there is nothing to be read in between the lines, and
you should go into these things. Mr. Shashi Tharoor, no doubt, is receiving support from everybody in the UDF. There is no doubt about that, and we are confident of our victory here.